What's going on, everybody, man? Doing something a little new today. I thank God for his abundance, man. We got a lot to talk about. I was sick last week, but y'all, man, God is good, man. We thank him so much for his healing power. I got to let my CNC family know what time it is. It's Godly Mindset Motivation, man. That's inspiring right there, man. I'm just so glad to be here, you guys. Let me go ahead and share this right now. I'm also actually live on YouTube today for the first time ever. So I'm trying something out. So I'm so glad that you guys are here today. So give me one second. Share this real quick if you don't mind, guys. Got a lot to cover. All right. Appreciate y'all so much. So I'm new to the whole YouTube thing, so I don't really know how to watch the comments and all that kind of stuff. So if y'all see something in there that I don't know about, if anybody happens to join that avenue, man, just let me know. So yeah, just trying something a little bit different today. But I'm excited, man. I'm excited because we always do what we do. We're going to go to God first, and then we're going to secure the bag. As always, that is not switched up, not one time. If you see me in public, I'm always the same. We're going to do that every single time. So today I want to talk about something that's extremely important, right? So, you know, the Bible tells us I think it's Matthew 6:24. All right. We had a conversation about this in the CNC yesterday. No one can serve two masters, for you will hate one and love the other. You will be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and be enslaved to money, to this stuff, money, right? What is this? Silver, gold, what? It means nothing. This is what we need. This is what we need. The money will come if we put our position in this beautiful book of knowledge right here. But that does not mean that God does not want you rich. It does not mean that God does not want you to live in abundance. Let me show you. All right. So join me in John chapter 10, verse 10. It says, I came that you may have life and have it abundantly. Abundance is from God. It is one of the most powerful and most beautiful things that God has given us. In fact, even when he used Moses to help deliver the people out of Egypt, right? Out of Egypt, he blessed them with plenty of wealth and abundance, but they misused it. They created idols. They began to worship it. They even made a statue of Baal, the bull, right? The bull that, you know, just kind of like the stock market bull, but not the same, totally different. But they worshiped this bull as Moses went up to get the instructions from God for the Ten Commandments. We cannot worship this paper. We can't worship it. We've got to position ourselves to where we are more hungry for God than we are a little piece of paper. I'm going to tell you something. In Ephesians 3:20 says, now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all we could ever ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. God wants to bless us. It also says in Luke chapter 6, verse 38, give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shake it together, running over, will be put into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you. So this money that we're making on the stock market, guess what? We could buy a lot of stuff with it. We could do a lot of stuff with it. But the best thing is blessing somebody else, helping somebody else in need. I challenge you today. Go pay it forward. Pay for somebody's food in front of you today for lunchtime or dinner time today. See somebody on the street. I dare you to give them $100 and don't tell nobody about it. You don't have to tell nobody when you're blessing somebody. You just do it, right? I'm going to tell you one more thing here. For God, In Matthew 13, 12, it says, for the one who has more will be given, and he will have an abundance, but for the one who has not, and what he has will be taken away. So you got to be careful as well how you handle what God gives you. My goodness, you got to be careful about what you do with the money that God is blessing you with, right? Again, we don't want to worship that stuff. It's going to come. But what you do with it, right? What you do, how you help somebody else out, how much more patient that you are with positioning for an options contract or a cryptocurrency, and it taking the dips, right? And you're not saying, oh, I lost my money, I'm a sell, my stock is red. No, be patient. The market is using itself in this situation here to draw you closer to God. It's teaching you the power of patience, the power of not having emotions or quote unquote love of money, right? We don't want to love that stuff. Psalm 65. I'm dropping a lot of scripture today because God wants this word out. It is so important. It is so important. Your crown, the year, your goodness, and your past drip with abundance. The drop of the pastures of the wilderness and the little hills rejoice on every side. I'm telling you, I want that drip of abundance completely all over me, all over each and every one of you. But we cannot have the mindset to where we are so concerned about what that little red minus sign is doing in our brokerage accounts. We can't be concerned about that. Again, we got to get back to this right here. Lastly, Romans 5, verse 17 says, for if by the trespass of the one, death reigned through the one, so much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness reign in the life through the one Jesus Christ. There is not one day that goes by where I don't thank God for what he is doing in our lives. Not just mine, our, yours, me and you, us right here. God is doing something miraculous, and I ain't switched up not once. Y'all see me at InvestFest, everywhere I go. I'm always telling you, man, it's not about me. It's all about God. An abundant life is something that describes the teachings of Jesus Christ, the teachings of God, what God really wants for us. Right? It's not about the paper. The paper gonna come. And I'm gonna tell you, it was in that moment of complete submission where I gave my life to God, where I said, okay, God, you want to use me to share the gospel? Do it. I'm here. Let's go. Then he exposed me to what? Armando Pantoja, right? Taught me how to do options. My entire life changed. Not only that, I lost on my first play. I wasn't thinking about nothing. I'm just telling you. You never know what happens when you position your mindset to be in the will of God first before you are thinking about that paper that comes on the other end. So let me tell you something. In that same process, you have to be so careful in the things that you are saying, the things that you are thinking, and the things that you are doing. Be careful about that. In the word, it teaches us that out of the mouth flows the issues of the heart. That's from Proverbs 4:23. So keep your heart with diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. So you go ahead and speak you got that drip of a blessing. You speak that you love the Lord. You speak that you have abundance. You speak that you're blessed. You speak that you're a millionaire. You speak that your business is successful. You speak that you know this stock market game. You speak that Bitcoin is going to 100K or better. You go ahead and, like Latrell David said, posture yourself towards God. And I'm telling you, you will win every single time without question. There are no losses. It's just paper losses as long as it's in the brokerage, right? It's just paper gains until you sell. It's just paper losses until you sell, right? So position yourself with time, right? Time is patience. Guess what? Patience, time, all of that comes from where? God. It took him 7 days. Well, actually 6 days to create this wonderful world that we live in, right? And then he rested on the seventh day. So as you are making this money, you're getting excited about your crypto and your stock plays and the trends and catching these bags, right? As you're getting super excited, there's one important element besides the fact that you're going to have a lot of money someday, right? And that is take a break. I'm telling you, at 3 o'clock in Central Time, when the bell rings, it's a wrap. I don't need to get on Discord and talk for the rest of the day. I got 5 children and a beautiful wife that I need to spend time with. I got Kenpo karate students that I need to go and teach the kata, right? I have to clock out of just making money all the time. So I want you guys to be encouraged to do the same thing. Stay hungry, but rest. Stay hungry and study and then rest. Rest some more. Make that bread, but rest. Learn when to stop. Don't be sitting up there on Discord at midnight talking about some this, that, and the third. Take a break, my friend. Take a break. You are going to have every single thing that God wants you to have. You don't want to have something that comes from the enemy. Share this right now, y'all, because I'm telling you, somebody needs this word. Somebody needs to hear this. And I'm going to tell you one more thing before we transition to what's happening in the market, right? This is not gambling. Investing is not gambling. And this is not some gimmick. This is not some scheme. I haven't asked anybody on here to give me $1 since I've been doing this thing. You understand what I'm saying? We have been doing this strictly for the glory of God and for you guys to learn how to make money to provide for your family, to help somebody else. That's real talk. Yes, I have to sell my courses to teach you so I don't have to repeat myself, right? But I want you to be more hungry for God to do something powerful in your life than you are for me to tell you what stocks I'm looking at. For you to tell me, for you to come and ask me, what are your thoughts about this, that, and the third? But guess what? I'm going to give them to you, though. I'm going to give you my thoughts. But it's got to be when I'm ready, because I'm going to tell you, I got to clock out. I got to clock out. And you need to do the same thing. Prioritize your mental health, your spiritual health, your physical health, your business health, all of that, right? Not just your financial health. Because I'm telling you, you take care of everything else, the rest will come. All right. So God bless each and every one of you guys. Before I migrate over into the stock market side, I got to close this thing out with a word of prayer. I feel God in here today. God needed this word to go forward. And I pray that you share this once I post it, okay? Because this is so important. So Heavenly Father, we thank you right now for each and every man and woman on this live. God, we pray for the abundance that you have for each and every one of them, Lord. Father, you have been so wonderful to us, so faithful to us, God. And God, we're not even worthy of all of the blessings that you have given us, God. But you are great, and we love you, and we thank you, God. So God, help us just check ourselves right now. God, help us to continue to love and put you first and not just chase the bag all the time, God. God, we give you all the glory, all the honor and praise. And God, we just pray that you give us the ability to bless somebody else today. God, it's not about titles. God, I thank you so much for everything that you're doing, God, but we just want to be pleasing in your sight. So bless each and every one of us. In Jesus' name, I do pray. And even for the unbelievers, bless them, God. And it is so. Amen and amen. Hey, you guys, I thank you so much, but we are going to migrate now to the stock market. You see what I got on. Unfortunately, YouTube, they ain't going to be able to take advantage of what's behind these eyes right here, right? You already know what time it is, right? So before I do that, if you haven't already hit that share button, we've got a couple of key economic things I need to address first. We got CPI coming out tomorrow. CPI will be released at 8:30 on Wednesday. And that will be a trend setter or a trend breaker for the market. Yes, I will be talking about cryptocurrency a little bit today. I got a few plays that I'm in, so I will be talking about those. If you could just let me flow, I got you. All right, we're going to go be on go mode. Oop, I think I just switched to my recording. Maybe these things are dead. I don't know. At any rate, so... but yeah, I will be talking about that. So CPI tomorrow, we got PPI on Thursday. And then I want to give you guys a heads up, mark your calendar, April the 10th. That's when FOMC will be speaking again. I don't know what I got to do to make this. Hold on a second. Let's see if I can make this thing pop so I can share this screen. Let's see here. It should work. I don't know. All right. So, yeah. There we go. Still not on there. Oh, well. So I did want to talk about a few plays that I'm watching. First things first, Google printed this morning. Google, they had that partnership with Palo Alto Networks, right? So this morning in the CNC, we grabbed those $157.5 calls, ran it up. They expired this Friday. Man, ran up for a quick 38%. Cool little scalp. And then it bounced again. Right now, we're seeing it literally hold support at that same strike price that we bought this morning, $157.50. That's exactly where it is right now. You go look at that 3-minute time frame, it has a buy signal all over it right now. I think Google is going to go to 160, right? And I'm going to tell you what I'm doing on Google. Understand that what I'm going to say right now is not financial advice. I cannot tell you what to buy or sell. I'm not a financial advisor. But I like the $160 calls on Google right now. All right. Can y'all hear me okay? I didn't even ask that question. I hope y'all can hear me loud and clear on both exchanges, because I'm talking to you guys through these things. And then YouTube has this wonderful microphone. So I'm buying 160 calls on Google out to May the 10th. May the 10th. Okay. I like this play. It's a little, I wouldn't say real expensive, but it's medium. It's about $5.23 per contract. Okay. But I think that this has a lot of upside potential. We've got a nice wall of resistance on Google at 158.50. All right. We'll break that at 158.70, and then we'll start testing at 159.60 and up. I think Google has a lot of potential because of the artificial intelligence migrations and enhancements that they're making in the company. OK, now, as I talk about Google, I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about Nancy Pelosi's new bae, Palo Alto Networks, ticker P-A-N-W, P-A-N-W. Now, let me tell you, this thing eventually is going to take off and be over $400 or $500. Okay. I really wish I could flip my lenses and share my screen with y'all today, but for whatever reason, this thing is not working for your boy. But I'll tell you that there is a beautiful candle on the 1-day time frame for Palo Alto Networks. It jumped up to 278.84. It's up 3.82% today. I do believe that we're going to get back to 280, maybe test 288-ish. But if we break 290.70, it is game over for Palo Alto Networks. They have earnings in 43 days, and I do believe they got something up the sleeve, right? I sound like my granddaddy with all these rhymes, right? I think they got something up their sleeves, right? Palo Alto Network, $300 call, May the 24th. Excuse me. My goodness, excuse me. May the 24th. Look at that, man. Them sinuses, man, they were kicking my butt, y'all. Last week, I could not even move. But Palo Alto Network, $300 call, May the 24th. I'm loving the setup. There's a buy signal on the 1-day time frame. This thing is going to run, all right? It is going to run, all right? So Palo Alto Network is going to be absolutely wonderful, a beautiful setup. And because of this deal with Google, I think it has a lot more momentum to the upside. I think Nancy Pelosi knew about this. She knew they were working on something. So if you didn't catch that, I've talked about so far Google, and I'm actually talking about the Class C Google, G-O-O-G today. Normally I buy G-O-G-G, I mean G-O-O-G-L, but I bought G-O-O-G today, and then I bought P-A-N-W today. Now, I'm going to give you two more. I'll give you two more plays, all right? And then we're going to talk about tickers, all right? So, as you guys may or may not have realized, something is happening, right, with student loans, all right? We're going to have to start back paying them back. Now, I don't know how many of you guys went to school and all that stuff. Hopefully all of you did. If not, I'm still proud of you. But I got a little bit of them myself because, you know, I just wanted to have a little money when I was in college, right? So it's time to start back paying those student loans. as that happens, there are companies that are going to be able to benefit from that. One of them we've been talking about for almost 2.5-3 years. Y'all already know which one it is. SoFi. So I want to start accumulating more shares of SoFi. I've also positioned myself today in a $5 call on SoFi out to 2026 and in the money play, right? So I like SoFi for that purpose. As we start back paying student loans, we'll probably see the revenue increase for companies like SoFi and other people that have done student loans because people hopefully will be paying their student loans. Who knows, right? But we're going to catch that momentum anyways, at least up until they report earnings. Now, I will say another thing I like about SoFi is they were just profitable last quarter. If we could keep that same energy in the next quarter, I think SoFi reports again in, what, 20 days? That's April the 29th. And this thing moves again above $10, I'm not going to miss that party. I'm not going to do it. So I'm loving that $5 call expiring January 2026. Lastly, another play, this is not the last ticker I'm going to talk about, but it's the last one I'm going to give you a signal on. I like GE Aerospace. All right. Now, somebody expressed to me today, they said, GE is not looking very good. Yeah, it may not look good at the time frame that you're looking at it. Zoom out, right? I love Rob Croak. He says, when in doubt, zoom out. But what he doesn't know, I've been saying that for years. All right. Love you, Rob. But anyway, the GE 165 call out to January 17, 2025 looks really beautiful to me. I'm thinking about earnings again here with this play. I had a really interesting conversation with my father this weekend. And I'm going to tell you, this aerospace division of GE is doing pretty well. All right. So I'm liking that division. I've got a couple of contracts. I'm buying the 165 call expiring January 17, 2025. Yes, this is an expensive play, but if you expect, if you take a rich play, you got to expect rich results, right? So that's exactly what I'm doing on GE. Now, it could bust. So, you know, just be careful. Make sure you know what you're looking at. If you don't know what you're looking at, you need to go to rogers1906.com or click that link in my bio or DM me and buy my courses, right? Because that's going to teach you what to look for. All right. Or join the CSC, right? And get the 50% off on those courses. So, again, the plays that I dropped on GE, Palo Alto Networks, G-O-O-G, and SoFi. Did I say SoFi? I hope I said SoFi. All right. Now, I also want to point your attention to a couple other things, right? There was news today that was dropped on ticker AIRC. AIRC. They're going to be bought out by Blackstone. What AIRC is, this is a apartment income REIT, a real estate investment trust. This thing shot up, had a beautiful God candle. Once this news broke, it jumped from $31 all the way up to $38.48. And I do believe that it will potentially have more upside as this deal gets finalized. Okay. I haven't even talked about this in the CNC yet because I've been waiting on entry and it looks to be hitting a wall right now. Excuse me. And if I go and look at that 65-minute chart, which is something that I like to look at, I mean, it's literally just trending the bottom of resistance at the moment. Okay. And it looks like it wants to go down, but it's not. All right. So AIRC, put that on your radar. Okay. Also, Tesla, right? Now, Tesla has literally gone off during the after party in the CNC. I told everybody, said, hey, if Tesla goes above 174, then I think it's got some momentum to go to 177. It hits resistance at 177, maybe touches 178. Well, this thing has been like, it's been tripping, but we day traded Tesla yesterday. And then today I hopped back in it for a swing trade at the 190 strike. I think I got an expiration date after earnings, right? Earnings are in 14 days for Tesla. But why it's moving, right? They got a settlement on their autopilot FSD situation. They settled that lawsuit. Secondly, they said that they're not going to sell cheap cars in America, right? They're not going to make the discounted cars. So again, investors are, they're already in it. They're up probably, but they're flocking back to a Tesla, and Tesla's moving. So there's a little bit of volume. This could be a dead cat bounce because, again, the last two quarters have been terrible for Tesla's earnings. But what we're going to be looking forward to is the guidance that comes back from it. Now, there's also been some problems with the Cybertrucks, so I'm a little skeptical about that regarding my swing, but I'm going to swing it anyway, right? So we'll just see what's going to happen with that. But that's why Tesla's moving. At this moment, I think that we still have just maybe one more pump to test 177.22 today. Maybe, just maybe. There's not a lot of volume at the moment because CPI is tomorrow. So we're going to see what happens. Maybe after tomorrow, it'll decide to move, or it may start pulling back just a little bit pre-market tomorrow. It just depends. I don't know. But hopefully everything looks good with CPI. Also, I saw something cool. Now, this one is an extremely volatile stock. Ticker ETAO. This is ETAO International. It's actually down a little bit right now. Down, actually, it's down a lot. It's down 14%. But the weekly has a buy signal. I think we're going to have a really, really small short squeeze to 449. Ticker ETAO. Very inexpensive. Very inexpensive. But I look at this one as a lottery play because, again, it's volatile. It could be trade sideways. So I haven't bought in, but this is a digital healthcare company. Again, we know how volatile healthcare is anyway, so I'm just kind of watching this one. So you might want to add that to your watch list, right? Now, I'm going to move on to this next one. Now, my boy AJ, Mr. Fallback, Alaric, I know I saw him in here. He loves this company. This company, I do believe, is now also something that we need to start back watching, right? And that is PayPal, ticker PYPL. He probably already knew what I was talking about. PayPal, it does have a very small sell signal at the moment on the daily, but the weekly is in a buying position. I see PayPal getting to $67.70, having a very small wall of resistance. But if and when we do break that, we're going to $68 and possibly going to test $70 within the next week to week and a half on PayPal. Again, as student loan payments go in and other things as far as like the banking and finance improve, I think PayPal will win. Yeah, there he is right there, LR.C. That is my guy. He is one of the voluntary analysts in the CNC. Make sure you go follow him. That's my brother right there. Make sure you go follow him. But anyways, 21 days, PayPal will be reporting earnings again. It has a lot of strong buying pressure at the moment. They say it's going to $70.26. $70.26. Guys, if you're on YouTube, share this with somebody. I wish I could see the live comments. I'm going to have to do some research on this stuff. Anyway, watch PayPal very closely. Now, I did see earnings are actually TradingView says that earnings are April 30th, but Earnings Whispers is saying May the 8th. May the 8th. So I really like PayPal going into earnings. Okay. So shout out to you, AJ, on that one. Also a couple things. Now these are just on watch, but I saw some unusual options activity, to the downside on this one, ticker PBR, Petrello Brasilio Petrobor. I can't say it, but I think that this was going to sell off. It's really choppy. It's sitting at $15.74. I got some little lotto puts for this Friday on PBR. This is in that energy oil sector, per se. I think it comes down to at least $15.23 by Friday. All right. This live will be reposted. Also, it's posted on YouTube. All right. So I'm also watching another extremely volatile ticker. I'm just giving you all the little things I've been studying today. But I think this one has a lot of long-term upside potential. Long-term, okay? Short-term, not so much. Ticker LASE, Lace. It's an electronic technology company. It's actually up 87% this morning. It was up 141%. 4.42 volume, market cap about 22 million. But they have earnings, or they had earnings on April the 1st. They were supposed to. I guess they fooled us because I don't see anything about it. But it's listed as a strong buy right now. Shares are super cheap on this thing. I haven't bought in yet, but there was a boatload of volume that came in today, actually in the past couple of days, and it's hitting a wall of resistance. It's sitting at the fair value gap right now. May dip a little bit. I think they're accumulating because long term, once again, this company is going to move. It had a prior high of around $7.20. Again, ticker is LASE. 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 All right, there's Laser Photonics Corporation. All right, so the last ticker on my list to tell you guys about today is ticker ACRV. ACRV. All right, now this is another health technology company. It's up 86% on the day. It was up a little over 112% this morning. Shares are pretty reasonable, $10.86 a share. Earnings are in 28 days. Last quarter wasn't so pretty for them, but they still had a surprise miss. Prior quarters were pretty dominant to the upside on ticker ACRV. 241.47 million market cap, but it has a strong buy with a potential price target of $19.44. Analysts are calling for this thing to even trade to $26 by the end of 2024. It's a strong buy. I don't know what news caused this thing to pump, but I can tell you that the setup, when you zoom out, looks pretty daggone good, right? So, again, I can see this one maybe in a year or two being over $25, but I can see $19 as more of a reasonable target for ticker ACRV. All right, so make sure you go trade the trend and watch that before you decide to jump in it. You can be safe with shares, or you could decide to buy a leap on your own. Whatever you do, understand that I won't tell you what to buy or sell, okay? So we're getting to the point almost where I'm going to ask you guys for questions and answers. But first, we got to talk a little bit about cryptocurrency, right? So I'm just going to give you guys a list, all right? A list of everything that I'm holding, that I'm buying. Of course, you know, Bitcoin is always in play. I actually haven't bought any more recently. I should have, but I'm just buying meme coins at this point. But I love SUI, SUI. SUI, USD. All right. Now, SUI, I bought that one on Uphold. It is a little down today, which is cool, but I think it's going to go back over $2. But SUI, USD. Also like Solana, of course. I've told you guys 1,000 times, Solana will be trading over $232. If you want to get a Saga phone, I got the link for you. Just holler at me so you can get locked in. But I love Solana. I think it's going to do extremely well. I don't know if I mentioned, but I'm buying Ethereum. I've been playing with it. I've got some that I just buy and hold just to scalp little gains from. And then I got some that I just don't touch, right? But I got a lot of Ethereum that I'm just holding on to, right? Also, guess what? I bought some more XRP. I didn't even tell anybody. I'm almost ashamed to even talk about it anymore. But let me tell you this. I bought some more XRP. I think XRP will have this settlement situation manifest itself. It'll probably go back over $1. But I got some that, you know, I just want to just sell as soon as it pumps. My boy, Lope308, I know he's loaded up on it. Proud of you, my friend. God bless you, my brother. I know he's got a whole bunch of it. And I want you guys to make millions off of whatever you're investing in so you can help somebody else out, right? But I'm buying XRP. I'm also loading up on, now this one's a little bit more. I'm buying a lot more of this. XLM. I like XLM a lot. And I do believe that the sky is literally the limit once the knee is off the neck of XRP. and Ripple Labs. Okay. XLM is going to be used as a custodian for a lot of ISO 222 transactions. So just keep watch. I'm telling you, you're going to be very surprised and be like, dang, Armando was talking about it. Mark was talking about it. So many other people were talking about it on Instagram, on YouTube. Why didn't I listen, right? So I hope that you are listening, not taking financial advice. All right, but that's not all. That's not all that she wrote. We got in on a beautiful play on Sunday. It went initial coin offering publicly on Monday at 5 a.m. And guess what? Well, it was 6 a.m. Eastern time, but 5 a.m. Central, which is where I live in Tennessee. So I bought some of our game, right? And I always get asked the question, where can I buy this? Where can I buy that? Now, I always tell you, you can go to CoinMarketCap, but in this case, I think it's going to be a little bit harder for you to find. So I'm just going to flat out tell you, right? So there's a website that's called r-games.tech. Now, I'm not telling you to buy it from there, but if you click that, it will tell you the five different locations that you can buy it, right? There are three centralized and two decentralized locations. Three of them, Gate.io, Mexi, and BingX, right? Nine times out of 10, if you click Mexi, it's going to say, this is not available in your region. Those other two may do the same, right? I have no problem using Mexi. I've been in it for a long time, but I'll tell you that that's where I bought my R game. Now, the other two places are PancakeSwap and Jupiter, right? A lot of times you could buy USDT if you have those exchanges, transfer USDT to those exchanges, and then buy it like that, right? Because some places they use that KYC, know your customer. I've never had to do that. Don't know anything about it. Don't use a VPN, none of that kind of stuff. So that's what I do. I buy it on Mexi. All right. Also, I bought PNG. PNG. All right. Now, this one I bought on Coinbase Wallet. All right. Pangolin. Right now, it's down like 6% on the day. But I do believe that when Bitcoin runs, when everything hits the fan, PNG is going to be able to take advantage of that momentum, right? It's kind of selling off a little bit, but the market cap is 108.59. Let's see what it's ranked at right now. Let's see. PNG. Again, I'm talking about crypto. It's ranked 467. So it's moved up and it's kind of pulling back just a little bit, but it's got about $7 million in liquidity. All right. So I like PNG. Also, I'm buying Brock. Now, Brock, I bought that on Coinbase Wallet as well. And none other than Robert Croke himself told me to take a look at this. And I'm still up pretty nicely on it. It's kind of been on a downtrend the past couple of days. It's actually, the volume's decreased by 5.92%. But I'm buying Bitrock, B-R-O-C-K is the symbol. And I bought that on Coinbase Wallet, okay? I'm also buying Proppy, right? I love Proppy. I don't have any Proppy keys, but I know you could also go and mint property and get paid for ownership of those keys of those properties using Proppy, right? But I'm just buying Proppy coin. I'm up 98% year-to-date on Proppy. I do believe it's going to $4, then it's going to $10 and possibly higher in the very near future. I'm also loaded up on Rio. I was talking to Tall Guy Tycoon this morning. I said, dude, you know what's funny? Before you started even talking about Rio, I already had it. My buddy Josh Hanna, I shouldn't say his government like that. My buddy Josh, he hit me up and told me about it a couple months ago. And this thing was up. It was up pretty decent, right? And then it sold off a little bit back in early April, like around the 2nd, I want to say. And then it went, started going back up a little bit. It's at 241 right now. I bought Rio on Mexi. Again, I don't have any information about VPNs. I just know what the CNC has talked about. But I bought Rio on Mexi. All right. All right. I got about four more. All right. I'm also buying Nakamoto Games, crypto symbol N-A-K-A. Now, I bought it on Mexi. You could buy this on Uniswap, you could buy it on KuCoin, you could buy it on BitJet, QuickSwap, CoinDCX, CoinX, eToro. So it's available in a couple other places, but Naka, I think, is going to do extremely well. We talked about our game earlier, these gaming tokens. I think that it's just imminent to where you can get paid to play games in the future, especially we talk about artificial intelligence. And you think about Ready Player One, people are going to be getting paid to stay at home. I don't know about y'all, but I like being at the crib. All right. Next, LCX, right? This is another one that we got from the Crypto Trends podcast with Robert and Armando. But I've been in LCX for a couple years. It's right around 34 cents right now. It's ranked 263. It's moving on up. We like that. We like moving on up. And it's just doing like everything else right now. Everything's kind of down because Bitcoin has the halving coming up. But guess what these people are doing? They're buying it, right? While we're panicking and worried about this green paper stuff, they're loading up on this stuff because they already know that people don't understand the detachment of emotions when it comes to investing. Now, the last two, Jupiter, J-U-P, right? Jupiter is also an exchange. This is through the Solana network. I love Jupiter. AJ loves Jupiter. I know a lot of people of Invest Answers, I think he talks about Jupiter quite a bit. That's actually where I first heard about it, J-U-P, because again, it's partnered with Solana. And I just think that this coin, this token, is going to do very, 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 very well. Watch Solana move. Watch Jupiter move. That's all I'm going to really say about that, right? I have like a $10 price target on this one as well. At one point, it was as high as $1.80, but I think it's going to go really, really high, really, really high by the end of 2024. All right, somebody asked me about my predictions on LCX. Since I just talked about them, I'll tell you. Excuse me. After the Bitcoin halving, LCX is probably going to be around 19 to 20 bucks. All right. So I like them a lot. Now, this last one is a straight up meme coin, right? I know for the longest, I didn't like talking about meme coins, but this one I'm only buying on the momentum of the election. Okay. So because of my normal career, I must say that I'm not endorsing any candidate for the United States presidential election. Okay. But I think that this one is going to run because of the election. And I'm talking about the MAGA coin, right? M-A-G-A. This is the Trump coin. It's ranked 296. But I think as we get closer to the election, just like you got that DJT, formerly known as, what is that? Jesus, I can't even remember the company's name. But I think that this coin is going to move. All right. Again, I'm just buying it for the hype and just not to miss the wave. I don't like to miss parties. Okay. So, and I'm not saying, again, I'm not endorsing DJI. Thanks, AJ. I'm not endorsing any candidate for president. DWAC. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right. So I appreciate that. And those are all the stocks and crypto that I had on my list this week. And now I'll get ready to take a few questions. But before I do, get your pen and paper out because I'll give you a quick recap. All right. That's what I do. All right. So I'm just going to go to tickers only. Tickers only. No plays. Talked about Google. G-O-O-G. Right. You also have G-O-O-G-L. All right. Talked about Palo Alto Network. Ticker P-A-N-W. A-I-R-C. Tesla. T-S-L-A. E-T-A-O-P-Y-P-L. S-O-F-I. G-E, L-A-S-E, A-C-R-V, P-B-R, right? Then we moved over to crypto, talked about BTC, Bitcoin, SUI, Solana, Ethereum, XRP, XLM, R-Game, Propy, Rio, Naka, LCX, Jupiter, and MAGA. All right, now, I see the first question coming from Bursting with Promises. Man, I love that name. That's pretty dope. All right, so he wants to know about Hood, Robin Hood. Ticker is H-O-O-D for the newbies in here. But I think that Robin Hood has a lot of upside potential after the Bitcoin halving, okay? I think that They have at least 6-point-something% of the Bitcoin holdings. But just looking at the current chart, I would expect a little bit of pullback on Robinhood. We'll probably find some support around $18.10. But if it falls below $17.83, Houston, we have a problem, okay? It will go back to maybe $15, okay? I think it'll probably bounce off of that level. But as we approach the halving on April the 19th, I think all of that could change, all right? In the meantime, while we're seeing all this red, all this fear, uncertainty, and doubt, FUD, as they say, they're just literally accumulating more and more of these companies. I think it's been upgraded. Morgan Stanley actually listed as equal weight just 2 hours ago, but it's getting ready to rally about 51%. All right. I think that if you're owning shares or you're in a long-term position, you're going to reap the harvest of a bountiful blessing with Robinhood. After this Bitcoin halving, after we see stocks go to new all-time highs, and most importantly, when we see the Fed or hear more about the Fed deciding to cut rates, let us get a good CPI print tomorrow. Let us get a good PPI print. We're going to see new highs like we've never seen before. All right. So I do like Robinhood is a long-term play. Short-term, just understand it's got to pull back. Zoom out to that one-month time frame, okay? I would put a target as far as $48.45 in peer view for Robinhood. Again, that's not financial advice. I don't have a timeline for you, but I can see it getting back there. Now, remember, at IPO, Robinhood was around, what, $18, kind of where, almost where it is now? I'm sorry, $36, $35. And then it shot all the way up to $88.64. This is back in August of 21. All right. So just imagine it getting where it needs to be now that we know how much Bitcoin they actually have. Okay. So I like that play. Good long-term play. But just understand that it's just got to go through its course of the market cycles, okay? And currently, it's just in markdown, all right? Cycles, as we know, as we were taught in The Strategic Millionaire, go buy this book on Amazon, it's $17. We were taught about the market cycles, okay? So make sure you go check that out, learn a little bit more about it. It's got to go through the cycles. Markdown, accumulation, markup, distribution, markdown again, all right? It's just constant process over and over and over again. All right. Now, moving next to NVIDIA. All right. So NVIDIA, that's what's really been moving the market this past week, actually. NVIDIA's been playing games with a lot of y'all out there. I ain't touching NVIDIA right now, other than looking at it for you. It's down to 841.28 short term. All right. But Jesus, what did I do with my candles? But I do believe that NVIDIA is still a sleeping giant. We will see $1,000 eventually on NVIDIA. I messed up my chart, so I'm trying to get it back up. Here we go. The truth still has a buy signal on the long-term play for NVIDIA, but we need to see this thing back above 975.14. Currently, I think NVIDIA could go back to 788.94, right? 788.94. Now, there is a little bit of support right there at 832.91. And I do believe that if it falls below 832.91, we are in trouble. All right. But again, with a good CPI and PPI print, all of that could change in the blink of an eye. But this is cool. We want it to pull back because guess what? It gives you an opportunity to buy back in for the upside, okay? So I like NVIDIA a whole lot long term. Analysts are still calling for this thing to go to 972.95. It's in a buying position. Overall, they do pay dividends. Earnings have been great. We've seen the momentum happen. We are in an AI bubble. And after May the 22nd, which is the next earnings date, Maybe that would be the driving force to change everything how NVIDIA has been trading. So right now, I just wouldn't get excited about anything short term. Long term, I think it's the GOAT, hands down. All right. So next one was Eli Lilly, ticker LLY. All right. So I used to buy Eli Lilly quite a bit back in the day. But a lot has changed, right? As markets change, we must change and adapt accordingly. Now, I'll tell you, Eli Lilly just got a buy signal today. I mean, literally today, April the 9th, and it's at 1:30 right now. There is a buy signal present. Now, where does it go from here, right? Is this even a real bullish play at this point? I'm looking at the 30-minute time frame. Let's zoom out to the 1 day. The 1 day got a little bit of a different story. It wants to sell off. But I think that ultimately we could see a bounce on the 30-minute, and it could roll over until tomorrow and get to 763.76. It's almost a 20-point jump, 10-point jump, 13-point, 12-point. 12-point jump, 763.76. And I wouldn't get too excited about Eli Lilly running until it breaks 770.85. I think healthcare is just so flaky right now. But I think that this thing is going to move eventually. There are a couple of lawsuits against Eli Lilly right now that has my level of skepticism pretty high in the short term. But long term, with the enhancements that they're doing for weight loss, what Ozempic and Mounjaro are doing as far as the brain, helping the brain as well, I think that it's a good company. They created a great product, and they got their hands on a lot of pots. But again, those lawsuits are troublesome and a big crunch on income for a company. That's an expense. Okay. So let's move on. All right. Next one I want to talk about. I see some of you guys asking about three of them at one time. I'm going to stay away from the miners until I get ready to get off of here in the next 8 minutes. I'll do that. That'll be the last thing I cover is CleanSpark. SoundHound. S-O-U-N, okay, S-O-U-N. So we got a dead cat bounce potentially present for S-O-U-N right now. It does have a buy signal at the moment, but it is a fake out. I think SoundHound will probably keep going down, like Mary J. Blige says in her song. It's down about 2% on the day. I have a target of about $3.44 on SoundHound. As NVIDIA goes down, I think this is coming with it. But again, that gives us an opportunity to reposition for the upside. Now, long term, I think SoundHound is going to do extremely well. They got earnings in 34 days. Last quarter was trash. They had a surprise miss down and dropped 25%. We caught it before the earnings because of the momentum, and we made a killing on it. But guess what? Right now, I'm just chilling on it. But I think that when NVIDIA moves again, this AI bubble burst, because we're going to see a huge gap up when that happens, SoundHound will go above 11 to 12 bucks, easy, because of their affiliations with NVIDIA. Now, overall, will SoundHound get back to where it was around the time when it IPO'd? I don't know. I would like for it to. I think it could get back to $18. But in this very moment, until we see something unique with revenue, unique with EPS, I just don't see it. All right. But expect that downside pressure to be in full effect. All right. Now, I did say a long time ago that by July 2024, that we will see Sound at $12.58. I'm still going to stand on that, okay? Because, again, that's after NVIDIA's earnings. Let NVIDIA report something and say SoundHound one time, and it's game over, all right? Let's see. Let's move on. Mark, TA on NEO, please. NEO. All right, cool. So as EV demand decreases drastically, and we see more drama between the U.S. and China, I just don't see our electronic vehicles performing as well as we would like them to on the stock market. Now, long term, as we see these relations improve, maybe with a different leader, president in office here in the United States, things could shift. maybe we'll start seeing some Neo cars on the road. But short term, I think that we're going to see a lot of consolidation, meaning the price is going to pretty much stay the same on Neo. It's sitting at $4.67. If we bounce off of these current levels, because the last low at $4.35 was weak, we could possibly test $6. But honestly, I'm just not seeing it. I'm not seeing that it's going to happen, even though this is extremely oversold. I mean, extremely oversold. And the secret sauce does have a beautiful buy signal. The truth has a beautiful buy signal. I think it's a trap. I really do. So all the candles, everything is below the 10-day EMA, the 20-day EMA, the 50-day EMA, and the 200-day EMA. Get that flawless trading system to understand that better. I just don't see it holding. Price is going to stay the same. All right. Even with this little 6% bounce that we had today, it's just not a lot of excitement going behind EVs at the moment. All right. So let's move on to the next one. All right. So we talked about NVIDIA already. Let's look at Adobe. All right. I had some $500 puts on Adobe. I should be kicking myself in the leg right now for not holding them. And Adobe's at $489.18. I'd be up like Chuck right now. You hear me? But it's so consolidated. Again, I don't think that we're going to see a lot of unique price activity on Adobe. It's up about 1.05% on the day. As I'm looking at it right now, it literally just bounced today and it's coming right back down where it was. It's got a sell signal present or sell signal forming on the 65-minute time frame if you're day trading it. But as long as I'm seeing candles below that 200-day EMA and we're just barely over the 50-day and the 50s below the 200, it's a no for me. I'm going to buy puts all day. And I think that Adobe could possibly come back to 477.38. But again, I wouldn't chase it. It's so low right now. We don't want to catch a falling knife. But I mean, why not? If it does happen to fall below that 477.52, it's going to 472.32. It's going to probably go lower than that. But there is a lot of support. So just be careful, though. I wouldn't expect anything, a whole lot of anything from Adobe right now. Earnings really shot Adobe in the foot. All right. I already kind of talked about XRP. I want to give you guys some ridiculous price prediction on it. But, you know, I told you what I was going to do. Let's look at SMCI. Bella Martin GS asked about Supermicrocomputer. I really like Supermicrocomputer. I had a inverted triangle drawn out on the one-day chart. We fell below the trend line on SMCI. It's sitting at $900.90. Sorry about that. SMCI sitting at $901. It just moved. It was at $990 just a second ago. But I think that it's got to go back above 967.78 to get back in the triangle. And then we could possibly start seeing 1141.92. If SMCI moves, IWM is going to move. And guess what else is going to move? MicroStrategies, right? MicroStrategies, MSTR. And I tried to include them in my video the other day, but for whatever reason, I think my mama or somebody called me and cut me off. So I didn't put that in there. But SMCI is just, it's flat. It's flat at the moment. It's getting ready to test that 50-day EMA on the one-day chart. And I think it'll probably bounce at around 844.93. But that's also solid put entry. At 844.93. I'll be watching to see what happens with CPI and PPI this week on SMCI. Okay. So that is that. Now, lastly, as I promised, I would talk about CleanSpark and then I'm going to let you guys go for the day. All right. So CleanSpark is sitting at around $15.48. Appears to be extremely consolidated at the moment. Right now, I can see it maybe finding more support at 1453 if it takes another drop, but I don't think it's going to go much lower than that. I think a lot of people ask in the CNC, how much lower do you think CleanSpark or Riot can go, right? if CleanSpark does happen to fall below equilibrium, I put $10.51 in my peer view, and I think that's where it could go. But ultimately, CleanSpark is going to $70. Within a year's time, I do believe it's going to get there. I even think that after the halving, it's going to $23.94 almost immediately. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, it is now power hour. I'm getting ready to drop the cat in the CNC. If you're in the CNC, you already know what time it is. Show me the power. It's time for power hour. It's the last hour of the trading market. If you haven't already, get the Flawless Trading System or shoot me a DM and get the everything bundle. I will do a special deal for you. Of course, yesterday's price is not today's price. That is lifetime access to anything that I teach. But most importantly, if you haven't already, join us in the Chestnut Checkers group. You can go to www.rogers1906.com. There's a link in the upper right-hand corner. Join us in the CNC and make sure that you share this live with somebody you know. I hope that God continues to bless you. You keep him first. And then secure the bag. We out of here. I'm covering up the wrong camera. All right, YouTube. I have fun with you guys today. I'm going to try to learn a little bit more about this stuff and get all the little pretty stuff like Armando does. So in the meantime, y'all have a good day. Sorry for covering the camera. Hope you guys gain some knowledge, especially if you're in the CNC or not. Share this with somebody. Pray that God blesses each and every one of you. Peace.